Next one is the finding the reaction of the this given section. So in this given section, you observe very carefully. So this is not a very typical previous problems whatever we have solved. It is not like that. See this problem, you can see here it is a fixed support at this end, and you can see the roller here, and you can see this as a concentrated load, this as a inclined concentrated load with an angle of 60 degree, and there is a moment, that's all. But there is a, you have to observe this, there is a one dark color dotted, it is there. So you have to be known this, what is this. So this hinge, whatever the hinge it is there, that is also will also be mentioned in the dark color dot. Okay, this also indicates here at the point B, support B, there is a presence of hinge. No need to show like this, whatever hinge I'm showing here, no need to show like this, rather than showing like this in the middle of the section, you can show the hinge point like this also. So that indicates there is a hinge point, we can also be shown like this also, that indicates the presence of the hinge here. Okay, so here you can, if hinge is presented, so there is a one section is this one, okay, another section is this one, two section will you will get it. Okay, so if you take like this, here to here it is a simply supported, but if you take here it is a cantilever section, so it will be cantilever, so you'll get a two section. So that's why what you do in middle, you divide this section, the whole section, whatever the whole section is there, divide it into two equal parts. Okay, here you divide it. Okay, so that one of the free body diagram of this typical beam section I'm showing here. Due to the fixed beam section, there is a two three reaction, one is upward, horizontal, and moment. So 10 into 4 40, it is acting at center 2 meter from here. So shown here, one upward and horizontal, because hinge, there is a two reaction will be there, so that's why bx and by. So if you divide for this section also, for the bc section also, there will be reaction will be there. One, if you show here this one up one, you have to show this one as downwards. So one moving towards the right, one it should be moving towards the left. Okay, to make it equilibrium, so you have to use the symbols like this. Okay, so here you can see this in 50 as it is, you put it moment 30, the due to the roller there will be one reaction, and due to the 20, and there is a downward concentrated load which is acting at a point D. So like this you have to divide it, so split into two sections, because if there is any presence of the hinge, you divide it two sections. Okay, later individually you take one section and find it how the previous problem we have solved, like that we have to solve it. So let's see how we will solve the problem. Okay, see here this section, so I will take due to three moment, three forces are there here. Okay, due to the presence of the three forces, one second, see due to presence of the three loads, three unknown reaction, one is upward and horizontal and a moment, there is a three reactions, so better you take moment at this only. So if you take moment at here, there will be two forces will be there, unknown forces, so we can able to manage. So that's why you take moment at here or here, it's your wish, but what will happen, so you can observe, you can find it here or here, but if you take a moment at here, there will be two unknown forces. If you take moment at this point, there will be three unknown forces, so it is very difficult to find it at the section AB. So if you come here at the section BC, there is a one unknown forces here, two unknown forces here. So if you take moment at this point, this only one unknown is there, you can able to find it. So it is very required to take the section BC. So it you have to decide the wisely, whenever the section given section is given, you have to decide it wisely. So here there is a two unknown, only here one unknown. So better to take this section. Okay, so better to take BC section as a for the analysis. Okay, so take moment at point B. Take the moment at point B. So you can see here the moment at B, you take it as 0. Take clockwise direction, anti-clockwise direction as positive. So here you have to, what is this, you have to resolve the forces. So like this, so one will be like this, one, two forces will be there. Theta angle is here, it will be so 50 sine theta. So this will be sine theta will be here, this will be 50 cos theta. Okay, so this force, whatever the horizontal forces is there, it will go here only, so there will be no distance, so this will become 0. Okay, so finally you left with this. So 50 sine theta will be acting here, so 50 into distance of 2 meter, it will be rotating in the clockwise, so it is negative. So minus 50 sine theta minus fine minus 50 sine theta into distance of 2 meter your return. Okay, next is here. So it is rotating in the moment it is rotating in the clockwise, so it is minus 30. Next is RC, so this one into 4, so but it is rotating in the anti-clock, so it is plus. So next one is this one, so concentrated load 20 into 6, it is a 20 into 6, it is rotating in the clockwise, so minus. So 20 into 6, so finally you find out the RC, you will get it around 59.19. So 59.19 you got it. Next what you do is you got this one and you have to find it this one. So take all the vertical forces, so sigma f summation of fx is equal to 0. So this one and only up, you take upward direction as positive. So this one and this three forces, so by and this 20 and 50 sine 60, it will be negative, so rest all positive. So you can see here there is a by, it is a downward direction, so it is minus y by minus in direction, and another it is this is also moving towards the downward direction, 50 sine theta, so that's why 50 sine 60, it is a downward direction. Next it is upward RC, it is in upward direction, so it is plus RC. So minus 20, it is in moving in towards the downward direction, so it is minus 20. So after substituting the value of RC, you have determined RC value, substituted, and only unknown here it is BY. Finally BY you will get it as minus 4.15. so finally you will get the RC value and BY value you have determined. So only rest of the things you have to determine is BX value you have to determine. So you put summation of horizontal force, sigma fx is equal to 0. So use sigma fx is equal to 0. So take only moving towards the right, you take it as 0. So here this force is moving towards the left, so it is minus BX. This force also, it is moving towards the left, so that's why minus 50 cos theta. So this is also BX, so both are in minus. So both are in the minus value, so BX and minus 50 cos theta, both are minus, you put it, and finally you will get the RC value. RC value, because both are BX value, both it is moving towards the left and this is also moving towards the left, so finally you will get the minus value. So that's how you will get the unknown forces here. Okay, but there is a reaction resultant force, you have to find it, BX and BY. So square root of BX square and BY square, so you have determined the BX and BY value, BX and BY value, insert the value, substitute the value of BX and BY, and finally you will get the resultant as 25.34. so tan inverse of BY, so this is the vertical force and this is the horizontal force, tan inverse of BY divided by BX, will get the theta angle of the resultant force. This is all the finding of this one. Okay, next is the another force, what you have to, another reactions you have to find it for the section AB. So here what you have to do is the for the free body diagram of any AB, you have determined So what you do is, initially there is a horizontal force of this one and this one, only two forces are there. You take the summation of the horizontal force is equal to zero. So bx is, you already determined earlier, so whatever the bx you have been determined here, so same the bx will be same. So bx here, it is moving towards the right, takes bx moving towards the right is equal to positive. So here the bx, you have to take the values, you have to take it for this section, but the direction you have to take it for this one. So now here summation of horizontal moving towards the right hand side is positive. So you have taken my right moving towards the right is equal to zero. So you can see here, you can see here ax is moving towards the right side and bx is also moving towards the right side. These are the two horizontal forces. So that's why ax and bx is equal to zero. So bx you have already determined in the previous section, so that is minus 25. Substitute the minus 25, you will get the ax value. Next you find, you take the summation of vertical forces. So summation of vertical forces, this one and this one, so three forces are there. So by you already determined in the previous problem. So by you have determined that one as 4.15. so summation of vertical forces, so you take it ay, which what are the upward forces, ay summation of vertical forces. So you know that ay is upward in positive, so it is in positive direction, so that's why ay it is in positive. And another is the 40, so that is also moving it, this one 40, it is in downward direction, so that's why here the minus 40, it is in downward direction. So by it is in upward direction, so by it is upward in direction. Okay, so substitute the value of by you have been determining the previously, that is my minus 4.15. finally you will get the ay as 44.15. okay, so after finding this, you already determined bx, you already determined the bx, by and ay and ax. Now you have determined the ax and ay, so finally you have to determine the moment at a. You have to determine, so determine the moment at a, what you have to do is, this is very simpler, very simple. See here, what you have to do is, so moment, see here, moment at a you take it. So bx, this it will go to here only, so leave it bx. So moment at a, it is you have to take consideration of this one more, this moment. So this moment is it is moving towards the anticlockwise direction, so it is positive ma. Next you come to this 40 into 2, so rotating in the clockwise direction, so it is negative 4, so it is 40 into 2. Next is by, so by here it is moving towards the anticlockwise direction, so plus by into 4. So this bx and ax is moving towards the a only, there will be no distance, so it will become zero. So okay, so next substituting the value of by, you will get the my moment at a as ma as 96.6 kilonewton meter, which is moving, it is a positive value, you got it, so it is moving towards the anticlockwise direction. So next here you have to find out the resultant force. So resultant force here, it is nothing but what, resultant force is equal to ax square plus ay square. Ax square and ay you have determined that here, ax value and ay value you have already determined. So just substitute the ax value and ay value as 25 and 44.14. so finally resultant force, you will get it arrow 50.74 kilonewton. Okay, so next here what you have to do is, next the resultant force for the ay and ax, you have to find out the resultant force. So for finding that result, for the angle between that, theta is equal to tan inverse of ax and ay. So tan inverse of a, tan inverse of ay and ay divided by ax is equal to theta, sorry, to find out the angle between the resultant force to the horizontal, so theta is equal to tan inverse of ay divided by ax. A value already determined, that is 4.14, and ax value already determined, that is 25. Substitute the values and find out the theta. This is for the theta angle at the support a. Okay, so this is how they you have to find out the reactions for the hinge support for the typical section. So here only you have to be careful if the hinge it is presented at this point. So make it this section, whole section, whatever it is, section is there. You take it AB as a one separate section and BC as another separate section. So this completes the finding the reaction in the given beam sections.